My dear students, let us start. This is second part, second lesson. So in this one, the first topic is Java interpreter as virtual machine. As I told earlier, in Java, we need Java compiler as well as Java interpreter, right? Why? Because Java compiler will convert source code to the bytecode, and interpreter will convert bytecode to the machine code, right? Machine code. And what we call here in Java, we call Java interpreter as virtual machine, or we can also call JVM, Java virtual machine. Okay, it is a machine. It does not exist physically. That's why we are calling it virtually, because it is in the form of software. And you know very well, software is a set of instructions which are giving to the computer to perform certain kind of task, right? So earlier I have already explained about Java interpreter. So remember that it only works as a virtual machine, right? What it does, it takes the bytecode and convert it into the machine code, right? This is the work of the Java interpreter or virtual machine. Okay, next is Java libraries. So libraries, if we discuss in real sense, so this library is same as, right, in the real sense, you know, in libraries when you go, so what are the things there? There are books. Inside the book, some informations are there, right? And that information we use, we read, we learn, and we try to remember it. In same way, in Java libraries, certain kind of informations are hidden, right? A certain kind of informations are kept. What to do? We have to use those informations, all right? Those informations, remember, what we are calling that library in real sense, in real world. But if we talk about computer sense, so we call that package. Inside package, some classes are there, and inside classes, some information is there, right? So that information we can use by the help of these statements. Okay, so remember here, import is a keyword which we use to include in our program, and this you can see java.io.asterisk written here. So it is a package name, right? So remember, it is a package name or library. How can we enter in this library? By the help of this import keyword. If we use this, so we can include in our program, right? And then whatever informations are there, we can use that. Now you may ask, sir, why we are using this information? Remember that if information is already available, so we have to use that information. We do not require to write that information again. Right? So remember that. And here, by default, there is a package name or library name, java.lang, lang for language. By default, it is always included in your program. Whenever you will start a program, you do not require to include this kind of library, this kind of package in your program, because it always inherited or always included in your program, right? So this is all about the libraries package. So you can see these are some examples: java.lang, java.io. So work of these libraries, these packages are different, all right? There are different kind of packages. Each package has a different kind of work, right? For example, java.io, it is used to deal with input and output statements. Java.lang to support string, character, mass, integer, thread kind of classes, okay, which contains this kind of data, like that. So these are the examples. You need to remember only the names, right? Next is Java reservoirs. So as you know, the meaning of reserve is something reserved for some special purpose. Same here, we have kept some words reserved for some special purpose. So whatever purpose is defined for these words, only for that purpose we can use these words. We cannot use for any other purpose. It means whatever purpose is attached to these words, only for that purpose we can use these words. There are 48 keywords in Java. Remember that. You need to remember only 2 or 3, right? Whenever you will start programming, you will get familiar with these all keywords. Most of the keywords we will use that, right? Okay, so remember that Java key reserve words are the keywords. Okay, or keywords, there is another name, are those words which carry some special meaning to the system compiler, right? It is already there written here. Very good definition here. So remember that these words are having special purpose, special meaning. Only for that purpose we use this. Okay, so this is Java reserve words. There are 48 reserve keywords in the Java, right? This is similar to as we reserve the seats in the train. No one can occupy that seat because we have make it reserved for our purpose. We can use that. Okay.